Hi, welcome to RoboJax. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use this stepper motor 28YBJ48 with the ULN2003 motor driver module for Arduino. So majority of the time people have issue with configuring this two together and not be able to use it. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you the code, and also the code will be provided at robojax.com. The link will be at the description below. This will be a very basic tutorial on showing you how to rotate this in one direction and also in the other direction. But maybe in the future I will create more videos to show you to use some kind of entrapped or other external factor or sensor or something that make the motor rotate or change the direction or slow down or speed up. But this is just basic introduction of this motor, how we can make it work or rotate with whatever direction we want. So let's get started. Have a look at the specs for this motor. This is the 5-volt type stepper motor. If you look this at the specs that is shown on the diagram, so here are the wires that you can see. This is the pink, and we have pink, orange, red, yellow, blue, pink, orange, red, yellow, blue, and here is the red one. As you can see here, the red is common between all of those. So the red is common, and then each wire represents a winding or a pole here. So they are a winding. You see number of phase that it says? It says 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, so it is the number of phase. This is the chip, and which I'm looking at the specs here. There are many variations of ULN 2001, 2, 3, 4. They all have A. They come with a DIP 16 and or SO 16. So this is surface mount version, and this is the version that we have here currently. And the difference is that the ULN 2003 has 5-volt TTL. And the 2002 works with 14 to 25, and also these are all the variations. That is why we are connecting this to Arduino, and Arduino's voltage level is 5 volts, so this works perfectly fine. Here the output, they labeled it 5 to 12 volts. This is connected here. If you look at the specs of the chip here, this chip has all of these inputs. And then it depends on number of the output that you use. On this board, we have only up to 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is used on the board. So the rest are, as you can see here, they have no connection here. So no pin. So we have only 4 input that we can use. We are using a 4-phase motor here that we are controlling. So what it does is, there is a motor, there is a diode for protection, freewheeling diode as they call it. And then we have an amplifier. So the signal comes here, inverted, and being amplified. Now the inputs are here that we will connect to the input 1, 2, 3, and 4 here. And these two go to motor. So the left side is marked clearly here as negative, and the right side is marked as positive. So these lights will show a status of each phase that will get signal. Here and here, the all pins that we have, pin 1, 2, 3, and 4. So 4 of those are connected from blue, and it goes on the Arduino. I've started, so the 1 goes to number 10, and then 2, 3, 4, it goes 10, 11, 12. The last one is common, and the common, I have connected it to the common. The circuit is powering up by Arduino, but the motor does not. So motor needs external power. It's very important. The circuit gets all the power from Arduino, but the motor needs power, external power. So you have to have some kind of battery or power adapter, whatever that you have, to supply power. And based on the specification that I was looking, this motor shows at 5-volt DC, so it will work with 5 volts. So to connect your battery, connect a positive here at the pin. The first one is negative, the second one is positive. Here we have a spot here, so this is for the positive at the middle. This is my positive, And in order to make this work, when you're connecting your power adapter, make sure that you connect your power adapter, the negative to the Arduino board and the positive to the motor. Or if you can split this and make it two pieces, that one negative goes to the board and the other negative goes with the power, that's also fine. Because the negative is common between the board and Arduino, I'm connecting the negative here to the ground, to the GND, one of the port that it says GND. So this is negative. And here is my voltage source here. I'm just plugging it in the negative here. And here is the positive from my source. So now, as you can see here, the positive is connected. The negative from this point is also connected to my power supply. The motor is connected. Because the Arduino doesn't have any power, it will not run. But before I power it, let me show you the code that I'm running and using. These are the pin on the chip. These are referring to these pins that we have here. And then 10, 11, 12, 13 refers to Arduino pins that we have here. It says pin 1 should be to 10, 2 to 11, and 3 to 12, so forth. This is determining the direction. So for clockwise, we say false. And for counterclockwise, we say true, which I'm going to demonstrate next. Then the setup part, this is the main Arduino function. It shows that pin 1, 2, 3, 4 should be the output. And then here the switch, and it says a step. Step is this one. Initially, when it is 0 at the beginning, it sends pin 1 to low, pin 2, pin 3, and only pin 4 is high. As you can see, the step when it becomes 1, also 3 and 4 is high. And then you will see that the 4 is off and the 3 is high. Slowly this goes 2 up and then 1. You see here it's at the bottom and then 2 high and then 1 low and then 2 high. It moves up and then 1 high and then 2 high at the top, and then it should come back to the bottom. So 1 high and then 1 high at the top, 1 high here, and then low, 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 all of them. So that's it. After this, it will be repeated. This is taking care of the direction. After 7, it just sets it to 0. The step will be 0, because in total with 7, because it starts with the 0, there is 8. Because we have 4 phase, 8 type of value will be enough to cover this motor and make it move. Connect the Arduino. At the moment, only blink is blinking. So this is pin number 13, which is just blinking here, as you can see. Let me upload the code into the board. The motor is, as you can see, is rotating now. And as you can see, this is running clockwise. To change the direction of motor, we just say here true. And then upload this and pay attention that this will first stop. It can go counterclockwise. So this way the motor rotates. Thank you very much. The code for this tutorial is available at the description by clicking at it and at robojax.com. If you want to get updates for future videos in regards to Arduino or any other electronic circuits, please subscribe so you can get updates. Take care.